हेलो, आई एम गणेश ब्यागलावे, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर. इन दिस सेशन ऑफ वेपर कॉम्प्रेशन साइकिल वील सी इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ VCC. लर्निंग आउटकम: एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू डिस्क्राइब वेपर कॉम्प्रेशन साइकिल, एक्सप्रेस द फॉर्मूला फॉर कंडेंसर हीट, compression work and COP. In the vapor compression cycle, in short, we'll be using VCC, stands for vapor compression cycle or system. This is the basic cycle which is used in the field of HVAC. In VCC, there are four devices are there. First one is the compressor, followed by condenser, expansion valve, evaporator. Now, this is the symbol for compressor. The function of compressor is to compress the vapor refrigerant. For theoretical VCC cycle, the inlet to the compressor is assumed as saturated vapor. So, compressor will compress dry and saturated refrigerant vapor into superheated vapor. After studying this schematic diagram, we'll plot the cycle on pH diagram. Now, this superheated steam is passed through the condenser. The condenser may be tube in tube type, shell in tube type, or shell in coil type. So, second device is the condenser. As the superheated vapor will flow through the condenser tubes, there will be heat rejection to the surrounding. So, total amount of heat rejected by the superheated refrigerant is denoted by QC. Now, obviously, the condensation process will be isobaric process, means constant pressure heat rejection process. After passing through the condenser tubes, the superheated vapor refrigerant will undergo the desuperheating process. Consider up to this 2 dash there is a desuperheating process, and from 2 dash to 3 is the condensation process. Means for theoretical VCC, at state 3 we will get saturated liquid refrigerant. Now, this process, which is from outlet of compressor to outlet of condenser, is isobaric, has high pressure or condenser pressure. The pressure possessed by this refrigerant is high. This pressure is to be reduced up to designed evaporator temperature. That's why we required one expansion valve. Now, there are different types of the expansion valves. First one is very simple, capillary tube. Second one is the thermostatic expansion valve, automatic expansion valve, internally expansion valve, externally equalized expansion valve. So, these are the types of the expansion valves. Compression process was isentropic compression process. The condensation process was isobaric condensation process. But here, in the expansion valve, the type of process takes place is known as isenthalpic. So, the enthalpy during expansion process, that is throttling process, remains same. That's why the saturated liquid will undergo the throttling process, and outlet of expansion valve will get low pressure wet refrigerant. So, this wet refrigerant will possess the low pressure. And depending upon the design temperature, it will have that low temperature. Now, we can pass this LP-LT refrigerant through the evaporator. Now, the types of the evaporators are same as that of the condenser, except flooded type of the evaporator or dry expansion type of the evaporator. So, this is the evaporator which is surrounded by this evaporator coils. So, when this liquid refrigerant starts flowing through the evaporator, it absorbs heat from the product to be cooled, which is kept in the evaporator. For domestic refrigerator, we are calling this evaporator as a freezer. So, what we are doing? We are keeping the ice creams or any water for freezing purpose in the freezer. The heat absorbed by this liquid refrigerant will be, which type of heat? Can you recall? If there is a change in phase of the refrigerant, then the type of heat will be either sensible or latent heat. So, please recall. Yes, it is a latent heat. So, more amount of heat will be absorbed by this liquid refrigerant, which is at low pressure, low temperature from the stored product. This is nothing but the refrigerating effect denoted by QR. So, to achieve this refrigerating effect, the work supplied to the compressor is WC. Now, this evaporator is directly connected to the compressor. So, this is known as vapor compression cycle. So, this is the schematic diagram which we have studied now. Now, we will move to the pH diagram, because it becomes very easy if we will plot this cycle on pressure versus enthalpy. It has a saturated curve like this shape. This is the high pressure. We use the notation condenser pressure, PC. The pressure in the evaporator is low. So, notation we will use PE stands for evaporator pressure. So, this is the evaporator pressure. Now, point number one, that is the state of the refrigerant at inlet to the compressor, is dry and saturated. So, for theoretical VCC, we'll assume the state of refrigerant at outlet of evaporator or to inlet compressor is dry and saturated. So, 1 to 2 will be isentropic compression process. 1 to 2 is the isentropic compression process. Then, this superheated vapor refrigerant will enter into the condenser. Because of its high temperature, it starts desuperheating by rejecting heat to the surrounding from point number 2 to 2 dash. This is the tentative point I have shown here. So, 2 to 2 dash is the desuperheating process. Then from 2 dash to 3 is the condensation process. Here the phase will change from saturated vapor to saturated liquid. During that process, that is from 2 to 3, the condenser is going to reject heat to the surrounding, as the surrounding temperature will be lower than the condenser temperature. Accordingly, you have to design the condenser temperature, condenser pressure, nothing but the pressure ratio of the compressor. Now, we got the liquid refrigerant at outlet of the condenser. As this is the closed cycle, we required to reduce its pressure. So that's why this is the expansion wall. In the expansion wall, there will be throttling process. The enthalpy will remain same. There will be pressure drop from condenser pressure to evaporator pressure. So, 3 to 4 is the isenthalpic expansion process. In this process, there will be some loss of liquid refrigerant. And 4 to 1 is the refrigerating effect. Now, From this diagram, I can write the equations for compressor work, which is equal to difference in the enthalpy, that is H2 minus H1. Heat rejected by condenser is equal to H2 minus H3. Thus, I can derive the COP, theoretical COP of the refrigerator, which is equal to refrigerating effect divided by work consumption. Here, the refrigerating effect is during the evaporation, which occurs in the evaporator, so which is the difference between H1 minus H4. So COP of the refrigerator will be equal to H1 minus H4 by H2 minus H1. This is the theoretical COP of the refrigerator. If we'll assume this as the heat pump, then just I have to replace QR by QC, then it will become COP of heat pump will be equal to QC divided by WC. So this is all about a vapor compression cycle. For further study, you can refer refrigeration and air conditioning by CP Arora and WF Stoker. Thank you.